Good morning, children. Now today we will start with a new chapter, that is photosynthesis. Now children, photosynthesis, it is the primary source of all food on earth. You know that when plants photosynthesize, then only we will get food. And number two, this photosynthesis is also responsible for the release of oxygen into the atmosphere by green plants. And you know, how do the plants, they prepare their food? From raw materials like carbon dioxide, water, sunlight and chlorophyll. So we will do the details of photosynthesis in this chapter. First of all, let us do the history about the photosynthesis. How do the scientists, they come to know that how the food is prepared by the green plants? Now this Van Helmont, he said that food comes from water and not from soil. This was his experiments that he come to the conclusion. Then Joseph Priestley, plants restore to the air whatever breathing animals and burning candle removes. So whatever the breathing animals and burning candles they remove oxygen. So plants, they restore it to the air. So what is added by the plants? It is the oxygen. Then Jan Ingenhuis, he also conducted the experiment. He said that sunlight is essential for photosynthesis. He did the experiment in the aquatic plants and he saw the bubbles coming out from the water. So this he considered they were of oxygen. So he says that sunlight, only in the presence of sunlight he could see the bubbles. For this he did the experiment, and in the lab he put the algae in the water, and at that very surface where the sunlight was there, the bubbles they came, which released the oxygen. Then he said that plants produce glucose during photosynthesis. Then Engelmann, he said he did the experiment with green algae Cladophora, and what he did, he exposed the plants to this white light, that is big gyor, followed on the Cladophora. See, this is the Cladophora, exposed the plants, and he said that their plants absorb maximum light in blue and red wavelength. So maximum amount of photosynthesis, it occurs in the blue and the red light of the big gyor. Now then Van Neel, he did the experiment on purple and green bacteria, and he said that photosynthesis is light dependent. Hydrogen from suitable oxidizable compound and is used to reduce the carbon dioxide. So we will do this when we will do the mechanism of photosynthesis. Dear children, you will come to know how these processes, they occur one by one. Now after that, Robert Hill, plants use light energy to generate reducing power. Which is the reducing power? It is the NADPH, nicotinamide dinucleotide hydrogen phosphate. So this is NADPH. We will also see how this occurs. Now Theodore, he said that water is essential for photosynthesis. Immersion, it is also called as the immersion's effect. We will do it in detail also. He said that there are two photosystems. There is photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. So both are involved in the light and dark reaction of the photosynthesis. Then M. Calvin, we also call it as the C3 cycle or the dark reaction. Now for this, children, whatever it is, you will read your NCERT page number 207 and 208 for your knowledge. When you read it, you will come to know these points very well. Though they are very simple, I have given you just the information. Now let us start. Now let us do the pigments for photosynthesis. Now children, first of all, you should know what are pigments. Pigments, these are the substances that have an ability to absorb light at specific wavelengths. So specific wavelengths are absorbed by the specific pigment molecules. We will do the types of pigments and the wavelength at which they absorb the light and the photosynthesis is performed. Now, pigments for photosynthesis. Number one, children, if we see, there is a raw material, that is water and carbon dioxide, then there is sunlight. We know it about very well. Then these pigments, they are present itself in the plants. Though these raw materials we get from the outside, these pigments, they are present in the plants. They are of three types. One is the chlorophyll, number two is the carotenoids, number three is the phycomelanins. Now children, chlorophyll A, chlorophyll B, chlorophyll C, chlorophyll D and chlorophyll E. So there are five types of chlorophyll in the plants. And the main most important is called as the chlorophyll A, because it is the primary photosynthetic pigment. Chlorophyll B is also important, and these are called as the accessory chlorophyll pigments. This bacteriochlorophyll and bacterioviridin, they are present in the bacteria. Followed, then we will come to the carotenoids, and let us first do the chlorophyll. Now chlorophyll molecule, children, if you do the structure of the chlorophyll molecule, it comprises of the head region and the tail region. Head region, children, it is the porphyrin head, and tail is the phytol side chain. And this, I will show you the structure on this. Now if you see this structure of chlorophyll, there is the magnesium in the center, and there is bonding with the nitrogen. Four nitrogen bonds are there, and this is one ring, pyrrole ring. This is second pyrrole ring. This is third. This is fourth. This is fifth. So what is there? The 1 to 4 are the pyrrole rings. Then fifth is the cyclopentanone ring. What is it? Cyclopentanone ring. And these 1 to 5, they are called as a porphyrin head. Followed? Then, children, there is the, I have told you the side chain. There is a 20 carbon. 20 carbons are attached to the side chain, phytol side chain or phytol tail. These are the hydrochain. The hydrocarbons are there. And chain of 20 carbons is there. And children, if it is chlorophyll A, then at the R, you can see this is the R, it is the functional group over here. At this point, at the pyrrole ring 2, this, the R is there. This R, it if it has got the methyl group, then it is chlorophyll A. If it has got the aldehyde group, CHO, then it is the chlorophyll B. Followed? Now, from this, children, let us do the differences between chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B. Now, you can see this chlorophyll A. You know that at position R, methyl group, chlorophyll B, at position R, aldehyde group. This chlorophyll A, it is bluish green on chromatogram. When the pigments are obtained on chromatogram, film is there, photographic film is there on the chromatograph, then it appears to be bluish green. Here it is olive green. In reflected light, chlorophyll A appears red. Here it appears brownish red. In transmitted light, it appears green and it appears yellowish green. So these are the main differences between chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B. Now, let us do the carotenoids. Carotenoids, commonly called as the lipid molecules. Followed? Now, these carotenoids, children, there are further two types. One is the carotenes, other is the xanthophylls. Carotenes are C40, H56. And xanthophylls are C40, H56O2. This is the formula. It is orange red. It is yellowish brown. For example, fucoxanthin, lutein. These are the examples. Fucoxanthin. You have done this in the your chapter algae also. Different types. And phycobilins. Phycobilins, third pigment. This third pigment, phycobilins. It is present in blue-green algae. Blue-green algae, phycobilins is present. And phyco, it is further of two types. One is the phycocyanin, other is the phycoerythrin. This phycocyanin, it is a purple. Here no magnesium is there. This phycoerythrin, it is red. It gives red color to the algae. We have seen a red colored algae, brown algae. We have done that. So here no phytol tail is present. One point you must know about this. Now, children, we will do the accessory pigments. As I have told you, chlorophyll A is the major primary photosynthetic pigments, other pigments. Now, what these accessory pigments do? They absorb light and transfer the energy to chlorophyll A. So, whatever energy is absorbed by the accessory pigments, they transfer that energy to the chlorophyll A molecule. So, chlorophyll A molecule, it is also called as a reaction center where major absorption of energy takes place, light energy. Followed. And number two, is it protect the chlorophyll A from photooxidation, so that there is an oxidation of the chlorophyll in the presence of a light. So these are the two functions of the accessory pigments. It is important. Now, if we see the chlorophyll A, children, it is the most important because it acts as a reaction center. I will show you the reaction center also, process of photosynthesis. So reaction center, here process of photosynthesis starts at the reaction center. So sometimes there is a one mark question, where does the process of photosynthesis starts? It starts at the reaction center of chlorophyll A. Okay, now all others are accessory pigments. Now site of photosynthesis, where this photosynthesis occurs, children, this diagram you have done in class 10th also, if you remember the topic of nutrition in class 10th. You have done the cross section of the leaf. We have seen that there is a cuticle upper layer, then there is the epidermis. Below the epidermis you can see this is the palisade parenchyma. Palisade parenchyma cells, you know, I have explained you earlier also. So here there are cells, rounded cells, where there are intracellular spaces present. This is called as the spongy parenchyma. Spongy parenchyma is there. Now both these, palisade parenchyma and spongy parenchyma, together it is called as the mesophyll tissue or the mesophyll cells. Total. And in these mesophyll cells, children, the chloroplasts are present. Followed? If I show you, this is the mesophyll cell. You can see this. Mesophyll cell, chloroplasts are present, in which the chlorophyll is present. And the chlorophyll, it is, if you study the hair, the structure of the chloroplast, again I am revising, though you have studied it in 9th and 10th, you can see that, children, it is the outer membrane, inner membrane of the chloroplast, and these thylakoids are there, ring-like structures are there, thylakoids, they are present stacked one upon the one above the other. And in these thylakoid structures, the chlorophyll molecules are present. Followed? Then there is the, here is the stroma region. This dot-like structure is the stroma or the matrix. Followed? In the thylakoid region, there occurs the light reaction of photosynthesis, and in the stroma region of chloroplast, there occurs the dark reaction of photosynthesis. Followed? Now, there are ribosomes present, and if thylakoids are arranged one above the other, they form a stack-like structure which is called as the granum. Followed? This granum and this is the stroma, these are the lamellae. This lamellae that is joining one granum with the other, that is called as the stromal lamellae. And you know that chloroplasts, they have got their own DNA. Followed? It is a plastid, it has got circular DNA. So this is the structure of the chloroplast. I hope you have followed about that. Okay, now coming to the light. If we see the light, children, the quality, what should be the quality of the light? The wavelength is very, very essential. So it is very necessary, you know that photosynthesis, it occurs in the particular wavelength, not in all. So rate of photosynthesis is maximum in a particular. Now I will show you. There is an absorption spectrum by using spectrophotometer. It is an instrument which can see the absorption of light by the chlorophyll. Now you can see Wibgeor graph is shown. Here you can see different types of chlorophyll are there. This is different wavelengths of light is there. You will see that this chlorophyll A molecule, it has got the highest wavelengths like this. It is at the B and it is at the R. Two maximum peaks are there. So from here we consider that chlorophyll A absorb maximum blue and red wavelength. It is depicted on a graph. Followed? And again he says that if we put algae in water, then more bubbles, many bubbles, they come where the region of blue light is there or the region of red light is there. Ethe katta na bubbles. Ethe bubbles are dikule zyada. Kyun? Ethe rate of photosynthesis is maximum. So experiments also prove that where does the photosynthesis occur to the maximum. Now, more the oxygen, children, more the rate of photosynthesis. Jinna zyada oxygen valu, oxygen, it is a product of photosynthesis. So if more is there, oxygen, then we will consider that more the photosynthesis is there. Next is, children, called as the emersions effect. We have done the emersions effect. Now see what is that. He says that rate of photosynthesis in different plants is measured in quantum yield. Quantum yield, what is quantum yield? It is the amount of oxygen released per quantum of light absorbed. Ek quantum light da jinni absorb hundi hai to usto kinna oxygen release hunda, that is called as a quantum yield. Now see this graph. This rate of photosynthesis is shown, this wavelength of light is there. After the particular, you know that rate of photosynthesis is going stable. But children, after a certain wavelength, there is a sudden fall in the rate of photosynthesis. So that sudden fall, it is called as a red drop. So what is red drop? It is a sudden decline in the rate of photosynthesis after red light. When 680 this nanometer comes, this wavelength light comes, then the photosynthesis, it falls. So this is called as the Emerson's effect, red drop. Now what Emerson did, he exposed the plants to shorter and longer wavelengths simultaneously. Unhe ki kita ki plants nu dono wavelengths te expose kita, shorter nu bhi karta aur longer nu bhi karta. Fir usne ki kiya, plants at 700 nanometer ਤਾਂ ਉਹਦਾ ਕਿੰਨੀ ਫੋਟੋਸਿੰਥਸਿਸ 10 ਕੁਆਂਟਮ ਯੀਲਡ ਸੀ ਸਾਡੇ ਕੋਲ ਇੰਨੀ ਕੁਆਂਟਮ ਯੀਲਡ ਸੀ 653 ਤੇ ਕਿੰਨੀ ਸੀ 53 ਇੱਥੇ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਸੀ ਫੋਲੋਡ ਅਤੇ ਉਸਨੇ ਫਿਰ ਇਕੱਠਾ ਦੋਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਕੀਤਾ ਟੁਗੈਦਰ ਕੀਤਾ ਠੀਕ ਹੈ ਉਸ ਤੋਂ ਕਿੰਨੀ ਆਈ 72 ਅਦਰਵਾਈਜ਼ ਕਿੰਨੀ ਹੋਣੀ ਸੀ 53 ਤੇ 63 ਹੋਣੀ ਸੀ ਪਰ 72 ਆਈ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਆਈ ਸੋ ਹੀ ਇਟ ਇਜ਼ ਕਾਲਡ ਐਜ਼ ਐਮਰਸਨਸ ਐਨਹਾਂਸਮੈਂਟ ਔਰ ਐਮਰਸਨਸ ਇਫੈਕਟ ਜਦੋਂ ਇਕੱਠਾ ਕੀਤਾ ਜਾਵੇ ਤਾਂ ਫੋਟੋਸਿੰਥਸਿਸ ਵੱਧਦੀ ਹੈ ਸੋ ਸੇਮ ਡਿਊ ਟੂ ਇਹ ਕਿਉਂ ਇਟ ਇਜ਼ ਡਿਊ ਟੂ ਦ ਟੂ ਫੋਟੋ ਸਿਸਟਮਸ ਦੈਟ ਇਜ਼ ਫੋਟੋ ਸਿਸਟਮ 1 ਐਂਡ ਫੋਟੋ ਸਿਸਟਮ